When I'm asked to evaluate an expression, what I'm really trying to do is replace the variable with a certain value. You can see the word value in evaluate. So I'm looking for a number for an answer. So for example, let's go ahead and evaluate this expression when h is equal to negative 4. When you evaluate, you want to be very careful that you include parentheses around the number that you're subbing in for the variable, particularly when you're dealing with exponents. That's where it's going to be really critical. Once you've subbed in that value, it's a matter of remembering order of operations. So some of you might remember PEMDAS, or please excuse my dear Aunt Sally, parentheses, exponents, multiply and divide, and then add and subtract. So just make sure you follow those, and be cautious about just typing everything in all on your calculator. I like to see work, and sometimes you can mistype something in, so just show your work. So let's start, and we're going to multiply and divide first, and we're going to go left to right. So first start with 6 times negative 4, and get negative 24 divided by 2, then plus a negative 4. I can't do my addition before I divide, so let's take care of our division. Negative 24 divided by 2 is negative 12, plus a negative 4, which I guess I could drop the parentheses at this point if I wanted to, but I end up with a final value of negative 16. Nothing too tricky with that. Let's move over and try the second expression when x is equal to negative 3. And again, you're going to see where that those parentheses with exponents is really going to come into play. So first off, let's go ahead and replace our variable with negative 3. Notice I have a negative outside the parentheses, the negative 3 in parentheses, and then squared. Minus 5 times negative 3. Big, huge number one mistake people make with these are they see the double negatives and they try right away to do plus plus. You can't do that because really what's going on is that's really a multiplication by negative 1, and then there's also this exponent involved. As you guys know, exponents come before you multiply. So first thing, let's do negative 3 times itself. Negative 3 squared is a 9. There's still that negative sign in front, though. Be careful, too, at this point, if you're using your calculator. If you type in negative 3 squared and don't use parentheses, this answer comes up negative 9, which it shouldn't, because then you have the negative in front. So just be careful that you're using parentheses around that first, or that negative 3 right there. Otherwise, just ask yourself, what's negative 3 times itself? And then that negative is kind of coming straight down. Over here, I'm going to think of this as negative 5 times negative 3. So I'm just going to put plus 15 right there. At this point, I can drop the parentheses and say negative 9 plus 15 and add those up to get a final answer of 6. And then finally, finishing up some of the basics. When I'm asked to simplify an expression, I just want to make it look simpler. Our answer might not be a number like we had up top when we evaluated. Our answer might be a complete different expression. So when you see the number outside of parentheses, you're probably thinking distributive property, and you'd be right. Take everything inside and multiply by the number in front. So I'm going to have 10n squared plus 10n. And then over here, here's another spot where people might make mistakes. Sometimes people look at this and think they're distributing a negative, or they think they're distributing a 6. And so they usually get the first part right, where they say negative 6n squared. But what the mistake happens is they think 6 times negative 2, and they put down negative 12, which isn't the case. What I do instead is I think of this right away. I change this to plus a negative 6 right there. So I remind myself that it's really a negative 6 I'm distributing. Negative 6 times n squared is still negative 6n squared. So that part was right. But then this negative 6 times negative 2 is actually a positive 12. And you may want to star that in your notes or whatever. That's where people run into errors. Now, I'm not done because I do have like terms to combine. Like terms are here and here. They have the same variables with the same exponent. So I'm going to add up the coefficients and get 4n squared. 10n doesn't have any like terms with it, so that just carries down as part of my answer. And then same with this positive 12, there's no like terms to combine it with, so just a plus 12. This is then my simplified answer. Notice it's not a single number, it's an expression.